And our shout-out tonight is an encore for one of the few investigative reporters working in Alaska, the 49th state. A reporter who we first recognized for revealing how convicted felons were able to get jobs as police officers in some of the state's remote villages. But over the summer, he stayed on the story like a good reporter, with some even more alarming findings that led powerful people in Washington to finally take notice.
My name is Kyle Hopkins. I'm a reporter and an editor for the Anchorage Daily News in Anchorage, Alaska. A lot of the stories that we want to cover and a lot of the best stories are in these far-flung villages that are hard for us to get to. There are all these small communities with all these small governments, and they work in the shadows. They do what they like because there's no one paying attention because their communities just are not large enough to support a local journalist. I found that again and again, you would see someone who had been accused of domestic violence or rape or homicide. And you would also find that person had at one point, and sometimes still was, serving as the village police officer.
As Hopkins discovered when he traveled to this village above the Arctic Circle, the village of Selawik, population 850. On a November night 3 years ago, someone gave alcohol to 16-year-old Lois Cleveland and then raped her.
She died that night, and while the medical examiner called it undetermined reasons, when Alaska State Troopers investigated, they found that she had handcuff marks on her wrists.
And the state police soon determined that the village police officer who reported the crime, Brent Norton, was in fact the one who committed the crime. In an interview recorded by state police, Norton admitted he had given her liquor and had sex with her while she was unconscious.
Did you do anything to her while she was passed out?
Yeah, I did.
What did you do?
I thought she was on to be with me, and I just tried to have sex with her.
It was not his first crime, Hopkins discovered.
A simple background check showed that he already had been convicted of bootlegging, and he was on probation for giving alcohol to another underage girl. So, gone through the criminal justice system, was accused of and found to be guilty of a crime, and was still on the job, used his city paycheck to buy alcohol that he then gave this girl. He raped her.
The young victim's mother was distraught.
You're supposed to be helping, not furnishing and taking her life or her childhood. Who hired him? How come they let him work?
And then Hopkins set out in the state capitol to ask the officials in charge if there were other police officers like Norton, convicted of serious crimes but still on the job.
And the response from this regulatory body, and their job is to keep track of this stuff, was, we have no idea. They didn't know. They said no one knew.
So that led to a full-fledged effort by Hopkins and the Anchorage Daily News to find out more, with a new report just last month, which found dozens of police officers with criminal records, including, Hopkins reported, this registered sex offender, Nimeron Mike, who was hired as a police officer even after serving 6 years behind bars on charges including assault, domestic violence, vehicle theft, groping a woman, hindering prosecution, reckless driving, drunken driving, and choking a woman unconscious in an attempted sexual assault. He was hired by the city of Stebbins on the same day he applied, according to Hopkins. Another police officer told Hopkins his criminal record would not keep him from enforcing the law.
Record? Do you think it affects your ability to be a police officer here at all?
Not really.
And earlier this year, new Attorney General William Barr came to Alaska and declared a law enforcement emergency.
Someone asked me why are you here? Why did you pick Alaska? It's because, to me, my job is to go where the need is greatest, and I think the need is greatest here. These are people that are just asking for the basic physical security, and it's not much to ask.
If felt like it's a story that I had been missing. I had been right in front of my face for years, and we just finally needed to address this. You know, that's really how it felt. Was like, you know, we should have done this years ago. Let's get this done and just tell people what's going on.
And he has. He is the recipient this year of a grant from the nonprofit ProPublica to continue his reporting as a kind of one-man wrecking ball against apathy and corruption.
I appreciate you putting a spotlight on local reporting. It's lonely. it's a lonely job. Nobody wants it out here. So it's nice to talk to somebody about it.
And good to talk to you. So a second and well-deserved shout out for Kyle Hopkins and the Anchorage Daily News, and for the nonprofit news group ProPublica, which has helped to support Hopkins' work as part of a 20-member local news network around the U.S., filling a very large void in the world of journalism. Well, that's our program for tonight. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you back here next week. Good night.